A very good day to all of you. Computer Shiksha is supported by. Do you all remember what all you had learnt during the last class? During the last class, you had learnt about the options like spelling, goal seek, pivot table, etc. And you also learnt about some formulas like PMT, PV, offset, column, row, address, etc. Let us go ahead and do some revision of these options and formulas. Can you tell why is the pivot table used? Using the pivot table allows you to see the summary of even a large database. You can also use it to summarize the count, average, and sum, etc. based on your requirements. Formerly, the pivot table was also known as data pilot. It allows you to compare your data or combine it and also allows you to analyze the data. For the source data, you can even see different summaries. Can you tell why the consolidate option is utilized? With the consolidate option, you can get to work with data from different sheets and you can use it to get the sum, average, count, etc. also. Why do we use the solver option? With the solver option, you can set the target value from the range of a row or column. What is the syntax to be used for IPMT formula? The syntax that you will need to use to apply the IPMT formula is equal to IPMT begin bracket rate semicolon periods semicolon num periods semicolon present value semicolon future value semicolon type and then close the bracket. Can you tell why we use the NPV formula? NPV means net present value. With the use of this formula, you can find out the value of your final return on your investment, which depends on the interest rate. The syntax that you need to use for NPV is equal to NPV begin bracket discount rate semicolon payments 1 semicolon payments 2 semicolon and so on and then close the bracket. Now all of you switch on your computers and open your spreadsheet files. Look at the data being shown to you and type in the same data in your sheet. Now, you will all practice the use of formulas. The interest rate on a loan for 45,000 is 5% and the time period for this loan is 5 years. By using any formula known to you, find out the monthly payments for this loan. Let us now watch the video and learn how the monthly payment amount will be calculated. Let us watch this video to see how we can use the IPMT formula to calculate the monthly amount or 2 months amount to be paid on a loan. So first we write a title here, loan amount, and then in the cell here where we want to type the loan amount, let's first go to the format cells box so that we can select the currency to be Indian currency. So in the format cells, make sure that the numbers tab is available, select currency, and from the format drop down window, drop down box, you can select the Indian rupee, INR. So now we just type the amount here and it will appear as rupees. So we can type 45,000. If the column width is small, you can increase it as is being shown in the video. If you want, you can make it 4500. It's up to you, or depending on the amount given in the problem. Next, we need to know the rate of interest, which is 5%. So we have written rate here and 5% in the cell opposite. Then for how many years is the loan? Year 5. So 5 years. Now we will find out the monthly payment amount. So we're writing the title monthly payment. And we will use BMT formula to find out this. If you want 2 months payment, you will need to multiply the amount which comes from the PMT formula with 2. So if we want to find out 2 months payment, we will need to multiply the amount that we find with the PMT formula, because that is monthly. So let's first use the formula here, equal to PMT, start the bracket, and then the rate. So the rate we know is 5%, we select that. Since this is an annual rate, we need to divide this by 12 to get the monthly rate. So divide by 12, semicolon, then year. So year is 5, but we want monthly, so we will have to multiply this with 12. So you can see that happening. Put a semicolon, then present value of the loan, which is 4500, we select that, and then type is 1. Close the bracket, and this is the monthly amount, 84.94 Indian rupees. This is actually 1 month's payment amount. So we are removing this 2 here, 1 month payment. So if you want 2 months payment, you will have to multiply this amount by 2. So that's a simple formula for multiplication. So get the amount star or multiply it by 2. So this is the amount for 2 months, 169.87 Indian rupees. So this is how you can use the PMT formula. Show how you will calculate the same for the net present value for a minimum of 5 years. In case you have doubts about doing this calculation, then watch the video and learn from it. Let us now learn how we use the NPV formula to find the net present value. In this CALCI sheet, we already have 2 amounts. So we're going to find out the NPV, net present value, for these 2 amounts. You can see here amount 1, 200,000 or 2 lakhs, and amount 2 is 1,50,000. So we use the NPV formula here, equal to NPV, begin bracket, then the rate, which is 5% annually. So we will pick 5% and then divide this by 12 to get the monthly rate, semicolon, pick the value 1, which is 2,200,000. So we pick that, select that, semicolon, and the value 2, which is 1,50,000 or 150,000. Close the bracket, and then when you press enter, you will get the net present value of these 2 amounts, which is 347,927.89 Indian rupees. So this is how you can use the net present value. Suppose you have 3 products, the target for which is 15,000 per year. In this, product A is 1500 and product B is 2400. Now how much should product C be so that when you add it becomes 15,000? which option will you use? Show how this will be done. Let us now learn by watching this video. Watch this video now to see how, if we have a sum total of, let's say, 3 products and we know 2 products, how we can use the goal-seek formula to find the third product. So we are first typing product A, product B, and product C. Product A and product B are known to us, but product C we do not know. So let's give the values. Product A is 1500. Product B is 2400. Product C we don't know, but we know that the target value or the total sum of these 3 products is 15,000. So we're writing target value and we're writing 15,000. Now product A, B and C, the total which should be equal to the target value 15,000, we first use the sum formula for product A, B and C. So we use equal to sum, begin bracket, and then we select all these 3 numbers, 1500, 2400 and a blank cell, and this total is 3900. Now we need to select the cell for which we have the total so that we can apply the goal seek formula. So we go to tools, tool menu, click there and then click on goal seek. A box opens and it says the formula cell which is already selected. Then the target value is 15,000. We can type that in. And we have to select the variable cell. So the product C which is variable, we select that. And then click on OK. You should ideally get the value, but you can see that goal seek has not been successful, so the correct value has not been found. Let us once again try this. We select the total value which is 3900, then go to tools menu, select goal seek, and then this is already selected, the formula cell is already selected, target value is 15,000. And variable cell we select from here, which is the value of product C, then click on OK, and you can see now the goal seek has been successful. So we can just click on yes from this box and you find that the product C value should be 11,100. And when you add the total of all these 3, you will get the target value 15,000. This is how you will use goal seek formula. Now, show how you will prepare a scenario for your sheet and write it using your name. Watch the video to know more about the use of the scenario option. Let us watch this video now and learn how we can use the scenarios option. For the scenarios option, we need some data. So, we already have some data on sheet 2. We are going to just copy paste this data onto sheet 3 and then apply a scenario for these. So we have just copied, we are using the edit menu to copy, go to sheet 3 and then just copy, now paste this data here. So we are pasting that data which we had already copied. We are just using the edit command so that you get familiar with everything. So we have this data now on sheet 3. Go to tools menu and select the scenario option. The box opens and then you can name the scenario. You can use your own name. So let's call it CS3. You can use any name. Click on OK. And you will see that on the data, the scenario option has been applied. So when you click on this drop down button, you can see the name of the scenario, which is CS3. You can also add some values to this scenario, and the values that you add will also get shown in this scenario. So this is how you can use the scenario option on your CalC sheet for any of your data. Now go to the next sheet and create some data on it. Note, in one cell, weekday earnings minus expense. Next, show how you will use the offset formula. And find the next column value of A1 column in the given data by using the offset formula. Similarly, show how you will get the value for each and every reference and also practice the use of it. In case you face a problem, watch the video to get clarifications. Let us watch this video and see how we use the offset option to get the value from our data, from the given data. So we have weekdays and we have the difference of earning and expenses here. You can see Monday to Sunday, we have all the weekdays and earning and expenses. The difference is shown 400, 450. Now the fifth row here is for Thursday, which is actually the fourth day of the week. So if we want to find out this value for Thursday, we can use the offset formula equal to offset, begin bracket. Then you have to give the reference, which is the weekday. So we select weekday, put a semicolon, and then the number of rows. So Thursday is the fourth one. So we put 4 here, semicolon. Then the columns, so since the earning expenses are in the second column, but if we count 0 as the first column, then this second column, this column will become 1. So we type 1 here, then put a semicolon, then we can just close the bracket, and you can see that the value for Thursday earning to expenses difference, which is 650, comes. If you want the value for Sunday, you can go to the formula bar here and make the changes here. A1 remains, the reference remains as weekday, but the row number is now 7. So we put 7 there and press enter, and you can find the value, which is 600 for the earning to expenses difference for Sunday. Now show how you will get the cell address. In case you have a doubt, watch the video to clear the same. Let us watch this video and see how we can use the address formula to find out the address of any cell. So for that, the formula we type equal to and then address. So we type address, begin the bracket, and then we need to select the row. So we use the row formula for this. We type row, begin bracket, and then select the cell which we want to find the address of. Close the bracket, semicolon, and then we have to type the column. So we again use the column formula. So we type column, begin bracket, and then again choose the cell for which we are trying to find out the address. Close the bracket, and then put a semicolon, and we can type sheet as 4, close the bracket, press enter, and you will find that it shows you D10 as the address for the cell. D is the column and 10th is the row for the cell where 600 is written, for which we were trying to find the address. So this is how you can use the address formula to find the address of any cell on your CalC sheet. Since we will now end this class here, all of you save your file, and then after closing it, shut down your computer properly. The next two classes are going to be very important for you, and in the next class, you will be practicing the use of important options from this part, and you will also practice the use of formulas. And then in the next class, you will be appearing for a practical test of this part. All students are being asked to remain present for these important classes. As you all would already know by now, if you are absent for the practical test, you will not be able to qualify for this module. So all of you must remain present. We thank you for carefully attending these video classes to learn about some very important parts of the spreadsheet. Computer Shiksha is supported by. Thank you.